My name is Torsten Aargaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world taking photographs and teaching photography. Today I will tell about how to always wear a camera and to do it in style. Today I want to tell about how to always wear a camera and to do it in style. And I happen to have made different products that is great for that. Here is my old Leica M9 that have followed me since 2009. I've taken like 200,000 pictures of it on it, and I made my own straps for it. And the straps actually say here, always wear a camera. It says in silver, and that's a quote by me. That's something I always tell people and I tell myself. So I also do that, and I'll just show how I do it, because not everybody knows. I put on my camera here across the chest, and it hangs here. If you see here, you see it hangs here by the hip, and then if I want to walk with it behind, I can just hang it here. And the way it works is that I'll take a photo of something and I'll basically just drop the camera. That's how I do it. So this way I can always have a camera with me, and it's not too heavy and it's not in the way. I have my hands free, and it has the exact length because it's hanging on my hip, so that if it hangs longer down, it hits my legs all the time and bumps back and forth. It's too much movement, and it's also annoying. If it is hangs too high up here, it's gonna hit my stomach and my kidney and everything, and I have to go to the toilet all the time. And then you have usually, and one of that's the reason I did my own strap, is that usually cameras come with too short a strap, or you would say a lot of non-Leica cameras come with a very complicated strap with all kinds of shoulder paddings, and you can adjust it and so on. A lot of plastic, lots of metal that is just in the way. And it should be very simple to just be a leather strap like this. But some cameras come with the two short straps, like you're supposed to walk with them here. And then, of course, some people can do that, and some like to actually have the camera here. I definitely don't. And that's what led me to make my own strap. And it's not that that doesn't exist. Great straps, because they do all kinds of styles, but I wanted one that was really simple and I wanted really high quality, and that's what I made here. And this one is the Concorde, so it's like a leather strap, and I have these just for decoration. This was actually the first one I made. That was the first idea I had. And this one have been a little bit expensive. I just lowered the price on the website 20%, so it's the same price as this strap, which is the Yosemite. And this one is the ultimate simplicity, you could say, because this is just a leather strap, and it's black calfskin, and then they have an orange edging here. And you could say Leonardo da Vinci said the ultimate sophistication is simplicity, or simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. And that's true. That's one thing I work with, because I work with my Italian designer Matteo Perin, and with our artisans in Italy. So we have artisans around Verona, Milan and Venice, that their families have been doing this for 100 years or more. So they have a lot of small tricks and a lot of know-how how to do things and how to treat leather and how to hand paint stuff. And I'm gonna just let you in on a few secrets on this strap. So this one is the traditional Leica, so they have a ring here, which I really love, this system with the ring. And then you need to hold the ring here, so the strap basically goes around here, and then it has some stitches here. One of the secrets I will tell you about is that these stitches are almost just for decoration, because the leather is glued here. So you could say if you hit something here, so the stitches goes up, the strap still stays. But it also means that we glued these stitches, so they stay there. It's very difficult to scratch them or do anything, so they actually open up. But should it happen, nothing really happens. The leather here is very soft calfskin, Italian calfskin, and we made different colors. And then it have a colored edge here, and this is like a special thing. You will see it on luxury bags, that you have this hand-painted edge. It's not always hand-painted, but this one is hand-painted, and the most exclusive brands are. And this one is hand-painted 9 times. So it's simply like somebody sits and paint it, wait for it to dry, paint it again, and they do that 9 times. And the reason you do that is to get the flexibility. Of course, it's pretty, it's orange, but you do it to get the flexibility that you can use it for a long time, that it doesn't crack and it doesn't fall off and so on. And you'll see if you buy, for example, I have a wallet that It's not cheap and it's not super expensive, but the etching on that one gets hard and then it cracks off. So that means I can have a wallet for 2 or 3 years and I have to buy a new one or just live with that it fell off. So that's the secret of this, or like the craft work that goes into it. It's not something you can just do at home and you just sit and paint leather. It's a whole technique and it's a long tradition. Then the thing that this strap is 125 centimeters and I also make 145 centimeters and you can get them made in your own length if you have a different ones, but this one will fit for most people. 125 centimeters is for most people built like me. If you're much taller, if you're wider, then you get 145 centimeter strap. And there's no adjustment, there's nothing you can adjust here that can fall apart or is in the way. It's just very simple and it feels amazing. Anybody who have bought this strap said this is amazing quality. One more thing that you can see in this one is that they actually have a thin layer. There's two layers of leather glued together, but they actually have a thin layer in between that it adds a little bit of stiffness, so it's not too soft, but it also makes it almost impossible to tear this apart. You can say even, it's kind of unlikely that you would do it with leather, but even if you did it, you actually can't because this thing holds it together. Also, an old tradition is in bags, often to stiffen bags. So there's no more secret about it than that, but it's something that you don't see when you get the strap. And these straps I've done in different colors. Here's the yellow one. And I've also done a new one in a monochrome. And actually here I have some of them. So I'll show you the different ones. So here's a green one that is Safarigreen. It's made for the Safarigreen Leica camera. Very beautiful, also orange etching. And this one is the Concorde with these stops here, or stoops. It's something that is inspired from horse riding where you have these stoops on the leather so you can adjust it to hold the horse. That's not why it's here, it's just for decoration. Then we have here a normal black one. Same as this one, but this is how it comes, this is how simple it is. And then I have here a new one we did is monochrome. So we simply did like a monochrome strap because I have a monochrome camera somewhere here. And I thought it was fitting. This is the monochrome I have here. So this is a black and white camera, black and white sensor only. So we made a monochrome strap. Also, some people they think, yeah, this is nice with the orange, but it lights up too much. I want to be more discreet. So we made one where the etching here is dark gray. And apart from that, it's the same strap and then has gunmetal color here. So it's not chrome, it's darker than chrome, but it's still a little bit glossy. But it's very discreet. And just for the fun of it, we made the camera pouch I have is also coming as a monochrome. And also the mini messenger bag I do comes as monochrome. And you could actually, any bags that I make, you could have it made with the monochrome look, just as you can get in any color leather you want, if you want orange or whatever you want. And then I have one of the great new things I have here is a Magnum strap that we made for the Leica SL. And you can see here, if you compare, this is like a SL and this is like a M here. And this is just a huge camera compared. And the straps are different here. It doesn't have any rings here. So there's like this metal thing sitting here that you put the leather through. And some have made nice straps for this, but they kind of tend to be very bulky. And I'm almost not lying if I say it took me 5 years to develop this strap. It's not true because it only took, I think, 1.5 years from we began to we made it. But it was a problem for me from the beginning when this like SL came out, that it was just bulky to carry. Also, often the lenses were big. My SL and like SL2, I used M lenses mainly and smaller L lenses with autofocus. I don't like the big lenses, especially not for walking around. So I made this strap and it's also the same as the other ones, like the same soft Italian calfskin and orange etching. And you can see this is a little bit wider because it could be a heavier camera. And when you get down here, it's not as wide because it has to fit into this one and have an adjustment so you can move this one to be shorter or longer. And I'll show you a brand new strap here just to show you how simple this is and how it's true that simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Because when you look at this one, it's just a piece of leather. Of course, it has always wear a cam on it, engraved with silver. But if you roll it out here, you will see that, maybe I can take this one off this way. It's not the right way to do it, but we'll do it anyway. So here, if you look at this, it's one piece of leather. There's no sewing it together or gluing or anything. It's just one long piece of leather that goes into smaller here, and then you fold it around the camera, and then you attach it in either this hole, or this hole. Very beautiful strap, soft and everything, and the response I get from everybody who gets this one is that this is like an amazing, beautiful piece of work, which I totally agree with. You could say it doesn't look like there's a lot of work in it, but there's a lot of work in making this precise and simple. So that's the point with this one, and it does, for me, it makes the SL feel like an M, almost, like 10% from there. And that's very unique, because before it felt like a machine gun or something like that, or I was carrying a suitcase. So that is mission accomplished, and that's the straps. Then let me just touch on another very popular thing I did that you don't need, but it's very popular, and that is leather pouches for cameras. I'll show you the monochrome one, because now I said monochrome before monochrome strap. And here's one, you can see it starts here, always wear a camera. That's a good beginning. And then when you open the back here, this is what you get. You get a camera pouch here that you could say cameras doesn't have to be in pouches, but it's kind of nice, and there's also people use this for makeup or for writing articles or just collect different stuff. And there's many great things about this one. Is also the key is simplicity. So the shape is simplicity, the way it's made, Italian soft calfskin leather. And then you see the zipper here is not straight, it goes this way. That is, I would say that's genius, because what it means is that when you open this one up, then you can actually open it like this. If it was straight, you couldn't do this, but this one you can, and then you can put in a camera. And the idea is simply just to take the whole camera here, and then you could say it's almost like teeth here, so then it just swallows the camera, and there you go. And then I will just usually just put my strap around here. And people use these ones for storage or for putting them in larger bags or just... And I think the reason this one is very popular is just it's such a cute thing. It's beautiful to touch and look at. You could say it doesn't make any sense. It's absolutely no textbook on photography that says you have to have the camera in a camera pouch. But it's very neat. You could say you can throw it in the back of the car or something. It is protected. But it's mainly, you could say, it is for the aesthetics of it. Some people have bought like different colors. You can get them in black with orange etching, the black here with monochrome etching. You can get, there's a red one here. I'll show you the red one, because if you want to give your spouse or somebody or yourself a makeup bag, then this is the one, the red one. You can also get yellow and green and blue. And maybe we make more colors, but this is really a piece of beauty. And let me just show what started it all, because I didn't start out with straps or something. I started out that I wanted to have a camera bag, not for walking around, but a camera bag for travel. And what we made was, we simply call it the Von, and it's this one. I'll move this one a little bit so you can have a better look at it. So this is simple, a travel bag like this. It also has a shoulder strap here, so you can put it over the shoulder. You can take off the shoulder strap, which I seldom do, but it would make it simpler, because I hardly ever use my shoulder bag unless I really have to through an airport or something. I have to go through security, I have bags all over. But normally I actually like to carry them the old school way in the handles. And a lot of things could be said about this bag. So one thing is, let's just start there. The handles here are made so that actually are really nice to carry, and of course they can last forever. And they're also pretty with orange etching and hand stitched and everything, and the metal here is amazing, beautiful and simple. And there's a metal things going through here you screw, and this one have gotten a little bit of glue so it doesn't go fall apart, because I had bags that fell apart, I mean the most weird places. So that's just a little detail, that this is actually a bag that is meant for traveling. This one have been through 12 countries with me recently. I just took it from the stock. I wanted to show it to somebody in Germany. So normally I have a crocodile one, blue crocodile, just because I'm exotic or something like that, eccentric. But I wanted to show the black one, so I took this one and I packed it. So this one was really packed to the max, through 12 countries, in and out of hotels and cars and airplanes and everything. And it is meant, the way I use my bag is I beat them up, like it's not like I throw them around, but I do use them. I don't take special care when I put them in the airplane or the car or something, like they get banged up a little bit, and it has to be able to withstand that. So then we have the size of the bag is made for, this one is made for the M system. Later on we made one for the SL system that is slightly bigger and have a shape like this. If you see them next to each other, we think it's almost the same. The SL is just a little bit bigger. But you see one thing it has is that you can actually open up like this when you unzip it. It's going to do it both sides. So you can actually get into it. You're not supposed to do like this, but it's just to show that you can actually open it. And this one has then inside, I'll just take an insert over here to illustrate that. So it has also an insert, you could say it's basically a normal, you could say weekend bag or document bag, but it has inside an insert that you can take in and out like this. And this is also a piece of art, and it has a label here, say always wear a camera. And then it has compartments here you can adjust, so you can put in cameras and stuff. And usually what I have in this one is like I have a camera in this button here, and then I'll put the strap here, and then I can put one more. Sometimes I take off the lenses, but I can actually do this and they don't really scratch each other, because it's not like I'm going to send them with UPS or something. I'm carrying it, so it doesn't really scratch. And then I have made mine here. You can move them, but I made mine so I can have a lens over on this side. And then it has, I'll take this one off so you can see it. This one sits here, so I can put this one here, put it back. Then I can put another lens, and then the same in this side. And then I could say, okay, I want to actually have not a lens here, but maybe I want to have a light meter, or maybe I want to just put a small camera or something like here. And I can actually do that with, I would have to adjust this one a little bit, you can see. And then one of the great things, because this bag is made for me the way I want it, so everything is great about it for me. But you see here, you can kind of sense it here, that you have space here. And if you see this one in front of the bag, you can see that it has space. This is not as big as the bag, and it's not attached in any way inside the bag. So the point with that is that you have space up here. So here I have something like 8 centimeters, that's 3.5 inches up. So I have here, I can put a water bottle, I can put a jacket or something, and I can still close the bag. It's also made so you can have a light reflector inside here, and you can still close the bag. You could also have a laptop here, it fits a 16-inch laptop. And it still has space here, you can see here it has space in the sides. So what I have in the sides here, I have pouches here. I don't need to have pouches, but I do. This one is for batteries, it's empty right now. Then I have one here where I have, let's just see what I have in this one, because I have many funny things. So I have a macro adapter, I have a light meter for the iPhone, I have extra SD cards, cleaning things for the sensor, liquid for the sensor, and I have a small pencil here to remove dust, extra wideband card, SD cards. So that's all those things just goes in this one that doesn't come with the bag, but I like small pouches, so I buy, when I see a nice pouch, I buy one. So that goes in the side, it has space, and it also have, I actually have one more here that I can put stuff in. So it has a lot of flexibility, and it also have in the ends here, have space so I can put in chargers. So here I have chargers in this end, I can stack two or three on top of each other. In this side I have a hard drive, and I can put hard drive in a charger, because of course you need your chargers when you go photograph, so where you're going to put them. So they have to be here, and it has to be fairly compact. And then this bag, let me just take this one out so you can actually see it, what it has inside, because this one have inside pockets, So there has one zipper department up here where I have cables and I have the SD card reader and stuff, and I have a cleaning cloth and stuff. And then it has here it has space for fountain pens or any pens. You can put two pens in it, and then it have 8 pockets. And these pockets are really good because it's made like the whole inside is a guitar like this one, so it doesn't scratch the camera. It's almost like cleaning the camera when you walk around with it. But it has 8 fin pockets in the way that they don't have zipper, they don't have locking mechanism or anything. It's just like spaces. So if you don't use them, they don't take up any space in the back. But you can actually put, you could put like a MacBook charger in one of them, and you can put a passport and business cards in the other one. They can get really wide, those ones. And one of them here hidden like an indie filter. So that's the idea, and this one is the original one that started out, that got me to work with Matteo Perrin, an Italian bag makers and leather specialists. It have taps here underneath so you can put it so it doesn't soak water and so on. So this is kind of like the original idea, and it's simply called the Von. And it comes in, we call this New York black. It comes in brown, blue, taupe, gray. And you can also, if you're really fancy, you can get the whole thing in crocodile. If you're less fancy and you still want to be fancy, but you don't want to pay a lot of money, then you can get the handles and other details like the piping made in crocodile. So we had a few who did that. But generally, this calfskin one is just beautiful. And you pick your color, blue or black or brown or whatever. And then this is made to last a lifetime. And that is kind of what it does for me. I love bags and I buy a lot of bags. And I used to do. After I got this one for my camera equipment, I actually haven't bought any other bags. That's like 5 years ago now. So this one is hard to beat. Once you have it, it's like, that's what you need. Then I fortunately I have a computer bag where I have computer and papers and headphones and stuff in for the airplane, and that one I can keep change. I can go look what does Louis Vuitton have and Hermes and Fendi and so on, or whatever I can find. But that is one of the values, that the reason I make my own stuff is that you could say the definition of luxury is that it's something that is worth repairing, but it's also, or that also means that it's something that can last for a lifetime or generations. And also luxury is that something is made exactly the way you want it. So, and in this case, I knew exactly what I wanted, and that's what I got. And then, of course, I made it available for everybody else. And so that's the story about the Von. Then I also made another bag, and that is actually probably the one I use the most, and also the one I sell the most of, and that is the Von Mini Messenger. And that one comes from the idea that it's nice to have a bag when you walk around. You can say the Von and the other bags I do are not meant for that you walk around with them in the city. And you are supposed to walk around and carry a camera, but then sometimes you need a little bit more. You need a battery, an extra lens, or you want to buy something, so where you're going to put it, because you need your hands free so you can take photos. So this is the Mini Messenger, and I'm just showing it here as a true mess. And I'll just put it on and show, even you're gonna lose my face when I do this, but this is how I carry it. So it goes here, and I'll show you why this one is a mess, because what I use it for is this one I take if I go from a hotel down to a cafe or to a meeting. If I go, I pack a bag to go to the car, and then I park the car somewhere and go into a building, I take this one. I also take this one when I walk around in a city. In general, I actually prefer to just have a camera, put a battery in the pocket, or if it's not too hot, I can wear a jacket, and then I have extra stuff in the jacket, so I don't have any bag. That's the ideal thing, but if I have to have a bag, this is the one. But let me just show how I also use it. So this is like, here we go, headphones stacked in there. It has a 16-inch laptop stacked in, and you could see that it can really close when you have the laptop. Then when you take the laptop up, now it's like a pretty soft bag. And I'll just show you the inside here. This one have, right now it has some different papers, and it's not an iPad, it's a Remarkable, so I can read books on it. It has some pens here, and more papers and pens, and I have a compartment here with where I have some cables, and even this one I have a passport and an SD card reader. But the idea with this bag is that, and that's another, well, it's not a secret, but it's a trick, is that when you buy bags, the shape of the bag is really important. So this one, I'll show you again how it sits. This one sits around the body like this. Of course, you can move it backward and forwards, but it sits like this, and you can see how it folds around the body. And it has this wide strap that you can adjust it a little bit, but it doesn't have any metal or stuff up in the top here. And the trick is that if you take a large Billingham bag or the Von, and it's completely empty, and you walk around with it every day, you're going to be tired from walking with it. When you take this size bag, it doesn't really weigh a lot, but you don't feel any weight of it because it hangs around the body. So that's an important little trick, and that's what's really important about this one, that it feels like nothing. And then you can put in stuff. I mean, you can put an extra camera, or you can put a lens. Now I've put all my lenses in in the bag here before, but I can put in a Q. I could also put in, let's just put in an SL for the fun of it. And this one doesn't have any padding, because if I wanted to pad it, you see here now we have a SL2 and a Q in this one, and it's kind of like it fits it. We can discuss if it looks pretty, that it's bulky like this, but it can be done. And you could say, often if I walk around with this, I would have it with extra batteries, some filters and stuff, where it's just a little bit too much to have in the pockets. Maybe have a light meter. I can also put a reflector in this one. It's folded reflector, when I go do portraits. So when I take with this one, I might have one lens in it. I usually don't bring extra cameras, but sometimes, like if I test another camera, I'll bring it just in case I see something, I can test the camera against that. But that's basically how I use it. That is like, you could say like almost like an overflow bag. It's just the things that doesn't fit in the pocket, or stuff you buy on the way, water, or you buy postcards or a little gift for somebody, where you're gonna put it, because you cannot carry a plastic bag or any bag, because you can't use your hands. So as soon as you buy something and you carry it, you can't take photos anymore, especially not with a manual camera. So that's the idea of this one. And this one again is very simple. It doesn't have a magnet, it doesn't have a lock or anything, because you don't need it. It hangs like this. The quality of it is made really for use. I can throw this one around. And again, it's a black soft calfskin, this one. Orange etching, and it has a Alcantara inside, so it's nice and soft, and it's really beautiful to look at. And even inside, it has orange etching, and it doesn't have a brand on the outside. It just has this little label inside, say orange label, say always wear a camera. And then, if you notice, a lot of bags you buy, they have on the strap here, when you hang it on the shoulder, then the adjustment sits here, so it really bites your shoulder. I don't know who thought about or who didn't think about that. So here we said, no, we're going to attach it over here. This one you can't do anything with, and there's nothing to adjust here. It's just the same width. It's very simple and soft and beautiful. But then over on this side, you can take this one out of this one, and you can move it, so you can adjust it a little bit. And that's basically all you need. I mean, if you had any special request that you wanted super short, super long, you can get it. I haven't had anybody who wanted that. So I think that's the story about this bag. It also have a so-called secret pocket in the bag. Is not very secret, but it's just where you can put in papers or something, gloves or whatever. And it's actually, you could say, it's a really big pocket, but again, it's like, it's when you don't use it, it doesn't take up any space. Very simple bag, and you can see it doesn't really have any metal to scratch anything. It's only have, this is the only metal on this bag. Really beautiful one. This one I have used probably for 3 or 4 years, and I really beat it up. And I don't know if you can tell or not. And I was looking if I had a different color here, but I actually didn't bring any. But this one comes in black with orange etching, and we made the monochrome edition with gray etching. I don't know if it's a limit or it's coming to stay. Then we have blue with orange etching, and we have brown with orange etching. The black one is probably the one we sell the most of. And maybe the brown is number two. It's kind of like the most flexible. And this one is also the only camera thing I know of where half of the people who buy this one is women. So this is great for women. It's not too masculine, and it's not, you could say, it's also not too feminine. You could say in the US, men don't wear bags like this usually. You go to Europe, men have bags like this that they carry stuff in all days. So apparently to the US it's a little bit too feminine, but I can't really say that I care about that. So that's one thing, and I do prefer to have a bag like this as a camera bag to carry stuff than to have a traditional square bag. So I just said I don't like square bags, and then anyways I made one, and this one is actually made because people keep asking about what do I do with like an SL, can you make a like bag for like an SL or like an SL2. So I did, and you could say this is, you could say it's very similar to the Mini Messenger in the idea that it has a pocket here and it's very simple closing, and it has the same strap. I'll open this one. As you can see, so it has the same strap system. This is brand new, so it comes with a strap here, it's attached here, and then you put it through here and you choose what length you want of it. And then it has compartments in here, unlike the Mini Messenger does have built-in compartments, because if we had an insert inside and then it has to be able to fit L lenses and like an SL, it just becomes too bulky. So you can say we save that space, we say okay, we're gonna build in the walls of the bag here, does have Alcantara and padding. And then it has this that you can move inside, and you can see here very easy. You put in one lens here. The height limits how tall a lens could be. If you have two small ones, which is almost impossible with L lenses, but you could have two M lenses then maybe. And then you can put in the camera over here. And it even have a little bit of space on top where you could put something. So you say it's not a super flexible bag, but it's like it is a walkabout bag. So you want to carry your like an SL with maybe a charger and one or two lenses, you can actually get away. Well, you could say three lenses, we could have one on the camera and then two next to it. That's kind of like the maximum. So that's the idea of this one. And that is simply what it is. And you could say it has like this shape here. So when it closes like this. So also if it rains, you don't get water in here. It's not something that you usually get water into your camera bags, but just in case, but it's also to just keep a nice shape on it. So that is the SL mini bag. I think that was what I wanted to tell you about today in terms of camera straps and bags that I have been working on and with and making and selling and promoting for the last 3 or 4 years. It's something that I'm kind of really proud of. I like really simplicity, I like high quality. And I like that it's handmade by real artisans that knows what they're doing. But go, there's links below the video here where you can go and look on the website and see the different ones, also the SL bags, there's like bigger SL bags and different stuff for that. And you can see the different colors and prices and everything. And that's all I will say about that. Also below the video is a link where you can get a free ebook and you can sign my mailing list so you get updated articles and videos and stuff all the time. And that's all I had to say. Till I see you next time, remember to always wear a camera.